Hello and welcome. I'm Peggy. Welcome to our kitchen and to some life-changing information. And I think you and I together have a chance to learn a lot. And we're going to talk about organic living, organic food. What does it mean? What is it? And why should we bother with it? We have all kinds of questions, and we have some experts right here, and we have some good ideas to share with you. And first of all, I want to introduce Rebecca McKinney. And Rebecca is the executive director for the South Carolina Organization for Organic Living. I have to get all these titles just right, okay?
That's a long one.
And Aaron Hicks is here. And Aaron is the program coordinator for the Swamp Rabbit Cafe and Grocery, which is located here in the upstate of South Carolina. Thank you very much.
Thanks for having me.
Welcome. Where do we begin? I think many people, myself included, are confused. We go to the grocery store, and everything out there is marked all natural. Everything. Well, I have my doubts.
Well, yeah, and all natural is one of those terms that really doesn't mean anything.
No.
But it's kind of, they use the term greenwashing. You're pretending like you're doing something.
Well, it's comforting.
Yes,
it's comforting.
It is.
Yeah.
And people fall into that trap. Even the people who know better sometimes fall into that trap. But organic is
all right. Now you brought some beautiful dips and things and some wonderful things for us to look at and learn about. We better begin at the very beginning.
Okay.
What does organic mean? When you go to the store, it costs a little more money. A lot of people talk about, what actually is it?
Well, if you're certified organic, that means that you have to follow a set of regulations set by the federal government, and it's about the sorts of pesticides and herbicides and practices you can use on your farm. And so it doesn't mean you don't spray it with anything, but it's with things that are much less toxic than conventional farms would use, more natural herbicides and pesticides.
Some people think that that's one of the reasons we have this cancer, it's like an epidemic in our society, is because a generation or two removed from us, they didn't have all these chemicals to use. I don't know.
I think that's a good point. And one thing that we've been talking about is that the World Health Organization just declared glyphosate a probable carcinogen. And glyphosate is the active ingredient in Roundup. And so many people use Roundup in their yards or at their businesses as an herbicide, as a weed killer. And so they've now said that there's enough evidence that we probably think it is carcinogenic. It does cause cancer.
Now, you brought some beautiful things that we can look at and share today. And you each are very much involved in this, I know. And Aaron, you are the Swamp Rabbit Cafe and Grocery.
Right.
So all of the things that you serve and the things that you sell are organic?
We're not 100%, but no. we try first to have organic and local. Then if we can't get that local, and then we'll go to a further regional organic. But definitely many of the things we sell are organic, and most of them are local. We work with over 150 local farmers and artisan producers who bring us these things literally on a daily basis. They come from all over South Carolina and North Carolina and Georgia. And just to tell you what I have here.
This is gorgeous.
Yeah,
it's like a picture.
I have this gorgeous basket of squash that is very much being harvested right now. You see the butternut squash. Maybe the less familiar orange guys there are jester squash. And then there's the green and yellow ones are sunshine squash. And they all come to us from Crescent Farms. And then I've got a basket of poblano peppers, which is a nice mild pepper to use in a chili or in a salsa dip. And that comes to us from Bioway Farms. And then in front there, I've got that big blue Hubbard squash. And that comes from Fischl in North Carolina. And that's you can roast it and eat it, but it's also a great decoration outside if you want to kind of create a fall decoration. So also, I have to share with you, I brought some of our baked goods from the cafe. We
We
bake scones, fresh bread every day, and the ingredients list looks like what your grandmother would have used, you know.
Let me get a plate somewhere. Let's see if I can find one here. Because we need to put this out so that people can see. This is beautiful.
And both of the two baskets in front, both of those are certified organic farms. And, and I did want Aaron to share the mission of Swamp Rabbit Cafe.
Now these are
There's a peach pecan scones and apple walnut scones, and they were baked this morning.
Oh my! So that you would consider with a good cup of coffee or a cup of tea.
With a cup of coffee or tea, yes.
So what, I tell you what I wonder about. When we go to the grocery store, and you, I take a long time because I read labels. And somebody told me once, why do you take so long in the grocery store? If I'm going to buy something, I want to know what's in it. Mm-hmm. And all these labels, and some of them are very deceiving.
Well, they are, and the first thing that we all know is that if you look at a label and you have 45 ingredients, we probably don't want to bring this product home with us because we know that there's so many additives. But you also have to know what you're looking for. And for example, a lot of us are aware of trans fats, and so in the beginning, we're having to read the labels and see if it had a hydrogenated or partially hydrogenated oils and stay away from that. And we kind of got used to now companies posting zero trans fats on their packages.
Yeah.
And I just found out yesterday that, in fact, they can have small amounts of trans fats and still call it zero if it's under a certain threshold. So you still have to look for hydrogenated and partially hydrogenated oils because these are the things that are going to clog you up, you know, not the good natural fats in moderation.
I think a generation or two back, our grandparents, great-grandparents, they didn't have all these chemicals to use.
No, they really didn't. And, you know, the chemicals are there, first of all, because they're cheap. And there's the thought that we all want cheap food. That's what's most important. The second thing is shelf stability. We want to be able to ship it from California and let it keep for 4 weeks.
That's the magic word.
Yeah.
That they can keep it longer. Mm-hmm.
And if you keep something that has lots of preservatives in it, you'll notice that it takes a long time to grow mold, if ever. But if you take something home from Swamp Rabbit Cafe and Grocery and you store it in a humid condition, you will see it start to mold. That's what we want. We want to know, because that means it's natural. If mold won't grow on it, then it doesn't need to go in our bodies.
What does sustainable agriculture mean? And it sounds so dramatic and so sustainable agriculture.
And I do want to say I am also academic program director for Greenville Tech's new sustainable agriculture program, which is a 3-semester certificate program. So when we talk about sustainable, most people who say they're sustainable farms, and this is kind of a what I call a loose description, they aren't using chemicals. They are growing, I'd say, organically, although they may not be certified organic. But we're also careful about how we care for the environment because we want to keep those natural systems working so that we can sustain our production. And we try to generate things on the farm like compost and grow cover crops to nourish the soil so we aren't bringing in petroleum products. And that's what the fertilizers that you'll go out and buy maybe at a big box store and it'll say 10, 10, 10.
Mm-hmm.
That's not natural. You know, as an organic farmer, I can use blood meal is natural, bone meal is natural, but what they're selling elsewhere is it's chemical.
So there's danger in this.
Mm-hmm.
If you consume this day after day after day. So what is your advice for the homemaker or for the person who perhaps they have an illness and they're trying to get strong again and get well? How can you help them?
Well, I think, so we have a good outlet like Swamp Rabbit Cafe and Grocery, and we have farmers markets. And get to know them, get to know their products, get to know how their farmers grow. If anybody won't share that with you, then I would steer clear. People are happy to share, and you want to buy fresh, and you want to use it fairly quickly because you lose a lot of nutrients after harvest. If you don't use your food quickly, which is another reason to maybe go to Swamp Rabbit and buy freshly harvested and delivered lettuce, as opposed to going somewhere and buying the salad right. mix that was picked four
okay,
weeks ago.
Okay, Erin, show us what is this?
Well, I just thought I would bring an example of something. When I got done with work yesterday at the cafe, I needed dinner and I needed something quick. So I walked around the cafe and I just selected this arugula from Thickety Mountain Farms. It's an organic lettuce mix.
This is, so you could put this right in a salad.
So I just washed it and tore it apart, and then I cut up one of these gorgeous BioWay Farms watermelons, which Chris, the farmer, did a second planting, so he's harvesting these again now, even though we had watermelons a few weeks ago. So I chopped that up in the salad to kind of balance the spiciness of the arugula. I added some of this Farmstead goat cheese from Possum Kingdom Creamery, who you're going to talk to later in the show. And chopped up a few cucumbers, added a little salt and vinegar and oil, and had a great seasonal salad that really didn't cost much at all. I can get a lot of servings out of these products here.
Yeah.
And my whole family enjoyed it.
So, okay, so if the whole idea is when you go shopping to read the labels and to plan to buy what you can afford that is chemical free.
Yes.
But that's, you know what? That's almost impossible. If you go to a regular supermarket, a big supermarket.
You know, it really is, and I've noticed that
that's scary.
And some of the larger ones have even declined in what they have that is organic. And I think the biggest thing is that if it's prepackaged and baked, like cakes, cookies, crackers, things like that.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, if you buy organic, it doesn't mean it's healthy. But if you buy organic of those things, it's better. But anything that has to be shelf stable, that's in one of the chain grocery stores that don't carry organic products, you probably don't want to take that home with you. I wouldn't even read the label. Just don't take it home.
Okay. So now your advice to all of us out there would be to shop when you can with the farmers market people who come on certain days, wherever you are, there's a farmers market, and try to buy the things that they produce. And they're not all organic, but they will at least be fresher than something you'll find in the supermarket. Now, am I right?
Yes, absolutely. And Swamp Rabbit Cafe and Grocery works with the same farmers that all of us work with at the farmers market. So if you can't make it to a farmer's market, or if you need these things after the farmer's market's shut down for the season, this is
right.
where you can come.
Right.
Well, we've got melons and cucumbers and peppers and all kinds of good things, plus some wonderful dips. These look gorgeous. So what we're going to do is go to a quick break, and I want to thank you both for coming and your knowledge. Then we're going to bring on two more people that have a lot of information for us. And of course, we do have a phone number, so stay with us.